Hey, this is Mike. Thank you so much for choosing this video. I am in beautiful Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, visiting East Coast Honda, the best Honda dealership in the country, according to me. And I'm checking out a 2017 Honda Ridgeline in the RTL-T trim level. And I am just blown away at the versatility of this vehicle. The bed of the truck is not like any other truck you've seen. And the interior is like a nice SUV, and it rides and handles like a dream. So let's go ahead and check it out. Here on the side, it has alloy wheels with a two-tone coloring, 18-inch alloy wheels, looking pretty sharp, not too flashy or showy. And this vehicle has four-wheel disc brakes with ventilated disc brakes in the front and solid disc brakes in the back. The name of this color is Deep Scarlet Pearl. Pretty interesting name for an interesting color, and it looks really nice, especially in contrast with this chrome here in the front. And I like that grille design, it's pretty unique. It has the plastic all the way around the vehicle there at the bottom, there on the sides, around the fender wells, to keep the paint from getting scratched and also to keep the the dirt at bay as much as possible anyway. So the headlights are powered by halogen bulbs in a projector housing here for the low beams and reflector housing for the high beams. You also have an LED accent around the outside, which is looking pretty sharp for a daytime running light. You have halogen fog lights here at the bottom as well. This is what the key looks like. It's pretty traditional proximity key with the lock and unlock buttons there. You also have the remote start and the panic button here at the bottom. You have the Honda emblem there. You also have a physical key. You just slide this open and a physical key will open up in case you need that. But typically you just keep the key in your pocket or in your purse and you can use the vehicle without taking it out of your pocket. With the key in your pocket or your purse within a close proximity of the vehicle, you can lock and unlock the door just by pushing this button to lock it. So now it's locked. I'm gonna try to hold here so you can see that it's locked. Okay, so to unlock it, you just put your hand behind the handle. It senses your hand position and senses the key and unlocks it for you. Let's take a look on the inside of the vehicle, starting here with the passenger door. Okay, so you have a two-tone black and beige color here on the inside. Soft to the touch, surfaces all the way around your arm here. You even have a metallic titanium looking accent there. And plenty of storage pockets. Check it out. You have little ones up here, bottle holder. You have a nice shelf type system with a pocket here, here, and also down here. So you can put a file folder, your mail, anything you want in there. So it's really versatile. Love the way they designed this door. So here's your threshold and your power adjustable seats here on the passenger side. And your seats are very comfortable. They're a beige leather trim seat with the perforated holes there because it is a heated seat. Kind of helps out with the heat transfer. Here's your floorboard. Let's go ahead and put this, make sure the seat's all the way back so we can see. Yeah, right there is your maximum leg room, which is very significant. You have a lockable glove compartment. Opens up and you have a smooth plastic inside, so that way it's easy to clean and just kind of keep it organized. So you can see it has a privacy glass back here, one panel in the back for your back glass so you don't have any blind spots to speak of. And looking from the inside out, the privacy glass is easy to see out of. It also actually makes it, improves it because it reduces the glare. So here's the inside of the back door. You can see it has the more forward cup holder there, little place to put your phone it looks like. Soft to the touch. All around your arm here. There's a storage pocket there. Speaker at the bottom. So here's your back seat, and it's pretty much a bench seat, but it does fold up in a 60-40 split fashion. You also have an armrest here with some cup holders and a little storage pocket, which you can move out of the way just in case you need a center passenger. Completely flat floor here in the back, so that way the center passenger doesn't have a hump in the middle like some vehicles. And you have a power supply, USB 2.5 amp power supply back here so you can plug in your phone. Now these seats will flip up in a magic seat type thing, sort of like the Fit, to where they can fold up like that. And then that way, you notice you have this flat portion underneath the seats as well, so you can slide things underneath the seat for storage, or you can fold up the seats and you can put whatever you want. I mean, it's completely flat except for this portion here to latch the seats in place. Other than that, it's completely flat, so you can put boxes in here if you want to keep things from being in the back of the vehicle, whether it be for weather, like it's raining or something, or if just for security, you can put your things back here and it keeps it locked up. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the back of the vehicle. Now this is the fun part. As far as this being a truck, really amazing features this vehicle has. So here's your back, there's your bumper, trailer hitch, which you can tow up to 5,000 pounds. It also has a 1,600 pound payload capacity, which is great. There's your backup camera right there next to the handle. Now the tailgate can fold down like the typical tailgate, like this. Just kind of fold it down like so. And you can use it just like a regular truck. It even has these places that looks like you can actually sit there and hang out. But also, let me fold this back up. You can also, right under here, it even says release. Just reach under here, you can open it up this way. Isn't that neat? And that way you can get closer to load up your items. Now sometimes, you know, you need to reach in there and the tailgate gets in the way, so that kind of solves that problem. You have some tie downs here, there on the front. You also have lights here on the side. Here's a little storage cubby where you can put some stuff in there. Now this is not metal, this is a composite material, which is super, super strong. It's nearly impossible to scratch it or dent it or anything like that. It's just amazingly strong surface. I don't know what it's made out of. If you know what it's made out of, what material, that'd be great. Just leave it in the comments. You also have a lockable trunk back here. There's the handle. You can lift it up like so. Kind of holds itself up, but spring-loaded, I suppose. Has a rubber seal around the outside. It kind of keeps water and stuff from going in there. And this is where your spare tire is loaded on this tray, where you can reach in and grab your hands here and slide it out once you release the little wing nuts here. And there you can slide it out and access your you slide it out and it actually rests on these little portions right here, so that way you can access your spare tire easier. So here's your storage space. It's like a small trunk in a vehicle. And it does have a drain plug, so you can actually use it as a big cooler if you wanted to. Or you can just put stuff in here and close it up and it gets it out of your way. You also have these little shelves here on the side. Bag hangers here, so you can hang a bag down in there. Here, here, and here. That's always convenient. Especially if you're just putting one bag in there, you don't want it sliding around while you're driving. So this is just an amazing, great feature. I love this compartment back here. This is fantastic. The fuel door is lockable and it's on the driver's side, which is convenient. Right here, and it's a capless design, so you can just put your nozzle in there, pump your gas. You don't have to worry about a cap or your check engine light turning on or anything like that. Now if you do use a gas can, you do have to use a little funnel that's provided, but other than that, it's as simple as it can be. To start the vehicle, there's the key. You just have to have the key inside the vehicle. Put your foot on the brake and push this button. Now this is if you're not using the remote start, of course. If you do use the remote start, you still have to push the button once you get in the vehicle to activate everything. So here's the floorboard in front of the driver's seat. You can see the floor mats hook in place. They have the little latches there to keep it from sliding around. You have a foot actuated parking brake, has your accelerator and brake pedals, and a place to put your left foot, a nice big place to put your left foot as well. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look under the hood. To open the hood, there's a little latch a little bit to the left of the center. There's the Honda emblem a little bit to the left of that, and you just move it to the right and you lift up. It's a very light hood, so it's easy to lift up, but it does require, there's your latch, it does require this prop to hold it up, but it has two positions. You have this lower position here. It keeps the hood, you know, kind of normal position, but if you really need to raise it up really high, you have this other position, which really puts that hood really up high and gets it out of your way. Now, that's what I'm talking about. Get that hood out of the way when you're checking it out. So, it's covered up with plastic, but underneath that plastic cover is an engine. It's a V6, 3.5 liter, and it's a direct injection iVTEC engine, and it has the multi-displacement technology, so it can cut back to a three-cylinder engine when you don't need all six cylinders to kind of save gas on the highway or just cruising speed. And it's paired to a six-speed automatic transmission. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look on the inside of the driver's door. It's pretty much a mirror of the other side with all the pockets there. But here's your, has a few more buttons. Here's your window controls. It goes up and down pretty fast. It's a one-touch up and down here in the front for the front two. And then you have door lock controls there. We already saw your fuel door release. Right in here, we have the traction control buttons, your cargo lights, you can turn those on, and your side mirrors, you can adjust them with this little pad. You just pick a side, and your econ mode button, give you better gas mileage. And there's your power seat for the driver's seat, power seat controls. You also have lumbar support back here as well. Very comfortable seats. You also have a tilt and telescoping steering column. So you can move it in and out, up and down, and you just lock it in place when you're finished. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the inside. Looking pretty good and very roomy. I'm very comfortable. This seat is super comfortable. It's not too intrusive. It's just a really comfortable seat. Now it's a hot day, so I don't have the heated seats on, but it does have those. So let's go ahead and start here on the steering wheel. As you can see, I have plenty of knee room and leg room, so I'm really comfortable. But here on the steering wheel, you can see it has quite a few buttons, but the steering wheel itself is very comfortable. It's a leather wrapped steering wheel, and it has this leather texturing going on as well. Let's see if it'll focus, there we go. See that has a little texture there that's very comfortable. It has the stitching there on the inside, little bolsters to kind of give you a better grip. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the buttons here. On the left side, you have a volume for your radio. You can change through your stations. You can change the source, like AM, FM, things like that. This button will cycle through different features. Like, so I'm gonna go ahead and push it so you can see. It goes from navigation, phone, or radio. So you just push that and it kind of cycle. You just rest on the one you want and it'll just take you there. Now, if you push this button, it opens up, depending on what screen you're in, different options. So you put that up, and then that way you can do some more controlling there. And the whole idea is to keep your hands on the wheel and eyes on the road, for the most part, while controlling the radio. So a little bit more advanced functions there besides just the volume and the stations. So down here is your Bluetooth phone. You can pair once you pair the phone, you can answer calls, hang up, and also has a voice recognition for making calls and also other features too. Here on the right side, you have your cruise control. You can just turn it on, change through your speed and cancel it there. And down here corresponds to the screen between the gauges, which we'll get to in just a minute. Your windshield wiper controls are there on the right. Right back here is your dimmer switch for your interior gauges. On the left side is your headlight controls. You have an off, parking lights, automatic, and a headlights, and your fog lights are controlled here. So let's take a look at the gauges here. So you have your RPMs there on the left, and your fuel gauge to the bottom right, and then your engine coolant temperature to the top right. But right here in the top center is your digital speedometer, so that's your speedometer for the vehicle. You also have these lights here on the side that will change colors depending on how you drive. So if you're staying in an eco mode, it'll stay green, and that green will fade away if you kind of floor it or whatever. So using these buttons here to kind of change through the screen, you can get some more information besides just the odometer and the outside temperature. I'm going to kind of scroll down here so you can see that's your average fuel economy, which is not accurate, by the way, and it also gives your range. For this is your trip too, so your distance at the top, and you have two of them, A and B. There's your digital compass, tire pressure, oil life, and then you can change to kilometers per hour if you want to, and then it goes back to your drive, kind of like a trip and a drive computer in a way. You also have a real-time bar at the bottom that kind of gives you a real-time miles per gallon as you're driving, so if you really want to sip gas, you can pay attention to that. Okay, so over here is your touchscreen radio. And the touchscreen, you have, let's go ahead and start here with the home button. So your home button, you have your navigation, your phone, information, audio, Honda Link, which is an app that you can put on your phone. Or you can plug in your phone and use like Apple CarPlay or Android Auto to project itself on the screen as well. And then you have a whole bunch of settings. Let's take a look at the navigation screen, just kind of give you an idea of what it looks like. Of course, you can put in a destination. I like the way it has a little car there. Good clarity on the colors too for the screen. All right, the phone. Well, once you pair the phone, we're not going to pair one now, but once you pair it, you'll have access to your, you know, recent calls and your phone book and all that good stuff, so you can send and receive calls. And you notice you have the, depending on what screen you're in, you have these little shortcuts up here as well. So let's go to the information so we can see what your trip computer looks like. You have voice info. You have, I like this. You can have a clock here on the screen. Also has the wallpaper there. So if you just want to have the clock nice and big for you, say you're running late and you want to pay attention to the time, you could do that. You can also see the date, and you can put a picture of your kids or whatever you want in the background. All right, audio. So this is your audio screen. You have your presets here at the bottom, tuned through the stations. There's lots of different ways of playing music besides just the radio, though. You have AM, FM, satellite radio, USB. You can hook up an iPod, Pandora. You can project from your phone. You can also play music wirelessly through the Bluetooth system. And then, you, of course, you have the auxiliary input to play music through as well. So tons of ways of playing music through the sound system. And I know some people are going to be like, hey, where's the CD player? Well, the CDs have been obsolete for at least 10 years, so it's time to make a change if you're still using CDs. Okay, so there you go. Your Honda iLink is a whole program. Like I said, it goes on your smartphone, and there's tons of settings here. We're not going to go into all of them, but you can go into whatever you want. You also have a volume here, as well as on the steering wheel. Your menu system here, you can cycle through that. And then you have a back button for certain screens, and then you have a day and night mode right here. Pushing this button will go into different apps that you have. You got a browser, you can go into like surf the internet using data from your phone or whatever. It's like a kind of like a Google browser here. And you can download stuff. You also have a calculator and all kinds of different things. So it's similar to an Android system, basically, is what it looks like. Okay, so moving on, you have your four-way flashers there, and then your climate control buttons, nice red candy light button over here. We already saw that for the start. But so your climate control is a dual zone. You have your temperature for each side. Right now it's synced together, but you can unsync it by pushing that button, or you could just adjust the passenger side and it will unsync them. You also have the fan speed there, your air conditioning, change where you want the air to blow. Of course, you could turn it on and off. It also has an auto feature. And then you have rear settings, so you can change the rear temperature back there, so as a tri-zone. Then you have your front and rear defrosters there. There's your heated seat controls for your driver and passenger. You have a little storage spot there. 12-volt power supply down here, as well as a USB port for plugging in your cell phone for that whole Android Auto, Apple CarPlay thing. You have a little storage place to put your phone or whatever while it's being plugged in. There's cup holders, One is deeper than the other, and then you have this little separator here, so you can use it, put your cell phone there or whatever. You don't always have to use it for cups. So here's your shifter. Let's go ahead and put it in reverse so we could take a look at the backup camera. So there's your backup camera. And then you have those guidelines there. They're active guidelines, so I can move the steering wheel and you can see they'll move and kind of give me an estimated trajectory of the vehicle. You also have different views. You have this broader view, a little bit closer, and then more of a top-down view. Now this is used primarily for backing up to a trailer, so you can back it right up to the hitch first try, so that's pretty cool. Moving on, we have the neutral drive. That's your normal drive position. It'll cycle through the 6-gear ratios. And then you got a low range. So this is if you're going down steep hills or whatever, you need a little bit of engine braking, you can put it in that. You also have a snow mode, which will adapt the vehicle to maybe, I think it starts off in 2nd gear, keeps you from having high friction takeoffs, that kind of thing. All right, so here's your kind of place to put some stuff here, and this opens up. You have this little tray that you can move forward and back. That moves back out of the way, and then we have this big storage area all the way back in there. You can really put a bunch of stuff in there, so it's going to get cluttered, so you got to watch out for that. And then you have right in here, you have a 12-volt power supply. You also have, this is where your USB and auxiliary inputs are located as well. Now this vehicle has an armrest for each chair, each seat. So it has a separate armrest for that. The driver and the passenger both have their own armrest. So this one is adjustable, so you can move it up and down, like up and up. And then you go all the way up to move it all the way down, like so. Okay, so let's take a look up here. It's a auto dimming rear view mirror. You have some tap lights. Now the interior lights, you can have them turn on, all on like that. You can have them all off, or you can have them turn on with the door with the center position there. You have the HomeLink garage door opener controls there. And this is where you can put your shades. And it looks like this is where the mirror would go on other vehicles. So I guess that's an upgrade or something. The conversation mirror. I guess you can just put one there if you wanted to. There's your visor, and you have mirror and lights for both sides. Let's take a look at the visibility in the back. Nice big one piece of glass in the back so you can see really good. Even with the headrest there, it's not really a big deal. You see pretty good on the sides, all around. Now, of course, the backup camera helps out with backing up, especially to backing up to a trailer. All right, so there you have it, 2017 Honda Ridgeline. I was super excited to show this vehicle off, and thank you so much for watching, and thank you to East Coast Honda here in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, for allowing me to show off an awesome vehicle. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.